So you're going to try to split between us and play both of us, and I'm going to score. Okay, if you commit all the way to the ball, then I've got to pass. It's my teammate for a layup. Alright, so I'm reading where he's playing. By committing all the way to the ball, that means I should read Adidas right in my path. Okay, so if I'm coming right here, he hasn't stopped me yet. He hasn't stopped me yet. He still hasn't stopped me, and I'm going to score. Does that make sense? So even if I miss this layup with him here, okay, let's say I miss, my teammate's there for the rebound. When we throw this pass, okay, that gives 2 seconds for that player to come back. Okay, and I've seen it on both courts. We're getting down here. Okay, we're trying to throw it. Get your hands up. Throw it over a taller defender. Okay? This pass, all right, ideally should be a bounce pass, and it should be right past his foot. Okay? So, if I have the ball in my inside hand, it makes it a little easier. I can come up, he steps up. All right? Easy pass. Okay? And it's quick. Okay, now, that's a good question. Okay, can you fake high and then make a step around bounce pass? Okay, in most situations, that's a good play. This situation, I'd say no, because again, it's time. Does that make sense? Okay, so, if it's that hard to pass the ball, so really make it hard for me to pass the ball right there. Okay, if it's that hard to pass the ball, that means I should shoot. Does that make sense? This is a hard pass to make, but this is an easy shot to make. Okay, so if they're that far into the passing lane, okay, it's probably telling you that you should have shot the ball. Alright? The other thing to make it easier, if you're running with me and you're off the ball, if you stay one step behind me, that makes it slightly easier to make this pass. So he cuts me off, now I make this pass, and his hand's out of the way. If I get all the way to here before he stops me, stand. Now you can stop me. And Jackson stops me here. Now there's a chance that he might be able to get his hand on this pass. Okay, but if he's one step behind, okay, I can make that pass without him in the passing lane. Do you guys understand that? Alright? So if you're running even with each other and you don't have the ball, you want to try to pace yourself one step behind. But if you're far ahead, right? So if I get the ball here and he's my teammate, then I want to pass the ball and then I'm trailing him naturally. Does that make sense?